Hello all. Today in this presentation, we are going to see about what is called as avulsion of tooth, a very commonly encountered phenomenon, and what are the causes and how we have to manage as a first aid therapy, what are you supposed to do at home before bringing the patient to the dentist office. So what do you mean by avulsion? Avulsion refers to any injury in which a body structure is torn off completely from its site, either due to trauma or surgery. So, in case of dental avulsion, it refers to a complete displacement of the tooth from the bone which is holding it in position. The tooth is held in the bone by means of certain fibers called the periodontal fibers, and these fibers are torn off due to injury and the tooth is completely removed from the socket. Here you can see that in the place of a tooth, you just have an empty socket and the tooth is completely knocked off from its position. So this type of injury is commonly seen in upper front teeth because they are the ones to be hit or impacted first by trauma. So what can cause this avulsion of tooth? Any trauma like a fall or a fight can cause injury to the face and the mouth. They can be either sports injury or traumatic injury or an accidental injury. This will either fracture the tooth or completely knock out the tooth. When it is a complete knockout, we call it as an avulsion of tooth. So, how do you know that the tooth is completely avulsed and not just fractured or traumatized? You can see a completely void socket which is devoid of the tooth, and there will be bleeding that is observed. You will not see any evidence of tooth at all within the socket or the ball which is seen in the alveolar bone. When such an avulsion happens in your household or to your friends or to your kids, what are you supposed to do? The avulsed permanent tooth should be gently but well rinsed with saline. You all know what is saline, what we give as drips in the clinics. And it should be taken care not to damage the surface of the root, because these roots will still have some viable living fibers and the cells. So when you tend to wash off or rinse the tooth, rub off the root, you may damage these fibers which are still alive. So once the tooth and the mouth are clean, you can attempt to place it back in the socket where it was originally placed within the bone, and the patient can be referred to a dentist office. But while doing so, what are you not supposed to do? What are all the precautions you are supposed to take? Never ever touch the root surface. Only hold the tooth by the crown. Crown refers to that white color portion which is visible outside in the oral cavity, wherein your root is the invisible portion which is attached to the bone. You are not supposed to touch the root surface because, as I have already told, it will still have some living tissues and cells attached to it. Never ever try to scrape or brush the root surface or remove the tip of the root. And if at all the root appears clean enough, try re-implanting the tooth into the socket. Otherwise, just bring it to the dental office. The necessary steps will be taken care by the dentist. If in case you are not able to, or if you are not confident enough in re-implanting the tooth to the bone or the socket, you are supposed to transport the tooth in a suitable medium. What are all the solutions in which you can transport the teeth to the dental office are your normal saline, or you can even use milk or egg whites or coconut water. Any of these medium can be used for transporting the tooth to the dentist. But take care to transport the tooth as early as possible, maybe 40 minutes to 1 hour. When you reach the dental office, the dentist will first examine the site for any lacerations if present, and then he will try to re-implant the tooth into the socket and then hold the tooth in position by taking support from the adjacent teeth. This process is what is called as splinting, and this can only be done by professional, and this can never be done at home. So don't attempt to just wire the tooth with whatever appliances are available at home. The dentist will be gluing the orthodontic wire by taking support from the adjacent tooth with a white colored cement like this, which is called as a composite resin. Once the splinting procedure is done, the dentist will want you to wait for a period of 7 to 10 days because this period is vital for the regeneration of the tissue surrounding the tooth. Now, with the help of an artificial support, we have fixed the tooth back in the socket. We would want it to be naturally refixed by means of the gum fibers or the periodontal ligament fibers. And we need some amount of time for the body to regenerate these tissues. So, we'll wait for a minimum of 7 to 10 days and then do a root canal therapy if needed and then place appropriate crowns in the position. Meanwhile, the dentist will prescribe you antibiotics to keep you off infection and also will prescribe you tetanus prophylaxis because most of the cases the avulsion happens because of trauma or fall. So any injury or lacerations might have got soil particles inside the injury for which tetanus prophylaxis should be given. And to keep you off pain, the dentist will prescribe you an analgesic and also to maintain the oral hygiene, you will be put on certain mouth rinses. But how much ever precautions are being taken and however earlier the procedure is being done, sometimes it may lead to potential complications like resorption, that is part of the tooth might be lost, or it may even lead to ankylosis. Ankylosis refers to pathological fixing, that is it gets fixed to the underlying bone so that there will be difficulty when you tend to remove the tooth in future. These are the potential complications that can arise in an avulsed tooth. To conclude with, an avulsion is one of the real dental emergencies which needs you to rush to the nearby dentist, and you should be aware of the appropriate first aid measures like how you are supposed to clean the avulsed tooth and how to transport, how early the treatment should be instilled. With all this in mind and put in place together, you can save the tooth to the maximum. Thank you.